1988, ladies and gentlemen, in 1988, Warner Communications, as then was, paid John F. Zengstack $28 million for the rights to a single song. I just want to know what it was. 1988. Yes,
a bit pricey.
It was. It was. They reckon they'll do very well out of it.
National anthem.
It was not the national anthem. It was not the copyright. Yes.
Was it the theme to Button Moon?
Lovely idea. It wasn't that.
Okie dokie.
Happy birthday.
Ah, thank you very much, Mark Gatiss. It was indeed happy birthday to you.
Aye.
She was composed in 1924. By a couple of old biddies.
$28 million.
$28 million. They make about $2 million a year out of it.
What did the people sing in 1923, for goodness sake? They brought the cake out, everyone just stood about in a slightly awkward silence.
Which is infinitely preferable than having that bloody song sung at you.
You're older, you're older, you're older.
Yeah, it was written by these two old things, and Irving Berlin included it with the words Happy Birthday to You, which they didn't write. Nobody knows who did write those. He included it in a 1933 musical, so they sued and won and retained the copyright. And in theory, if you sing it in a restaurant, you owe Warner Brothers money because it's counted as a public place.
You'd have to be very honest to phone them up and go, it was a birthday, how much do I owe you?
And I hummed a few bars and Let It Be as well.
Happy Birthday was the first song to be sung in outer space from the Apollo 9 crew. Do you know what the original song was written as, what the lyrics were? They weren't Happy Birthday to You, as I said.
It was a Death Row song. You won't be alive tomorrow.
Yeah. No.
Don't bother making your bed.
No. Really, really good idea for Ainsley Harriet would be Ainsley's Death Row Dinners.
What's the odds?
Because it's so jolly.
No, originally, it was written as a teacher's song to sing to their class, Good Morning to All, it was called. Then it became Good Morning to You, and then Happy Birthday to You. That's its history.